Determine the first and second derivative of the given vectored valued function, then determine r prime of pi over 2 and r double prime of pi over 2. Before we do this, let's look at this graphically. The plane curve, given by r of t, is graphed here in black. The point on the curve when t equals negative 1 is this point here. Notice from here we have a red vector, a blue vector, and a purple vector. The red vector is given by r of negative 1, the blue vector is the vector given by r prime of negative 1, and the purple vector is the vector given by r double prime of negative 1. If we think of r of t as the position function, then r prime of negative 1 is the velocity vector, which notice how it was tangent to the curve, and r double prime of negative 1 is the acceleration vector. Now let's animate these three vectors as t increases from negative 1 to positive 4. We will notice the red vector traces out the curve, the blue vector remains tangent to the curve, which is the velocity vector, and the purple vector is the acceleration vector. Let's do that again. For this question, we're asked to find r prime of pi over 2 and r double prime of pi over 2. When t is equal to pi over 2, this is the point on the curve. Pi over 2 is approximately 1.57, which is right about here. So r prime of pi over 2 is going to be this tangent vector, which we can think of as the velocity vector, and r double prime of pi over 2 we can think of as the acceleration vector, which is this purple vector. Going back to our work, let's begin by determining r prime of t. To do this, we differentiate the x and y components of r of t with respect to t. The derivative of 6t plus 2 sine t is equal to 6 plus 2 cosine t. Then we have times the unit vector I. Then we have plus the derivative of 5t plus 7 cosine t is equal to 5 minus 7 sine t, and then we have times the unit vector j. Now to find r double prime of t, we need to find the second derivative of the x and y components of r of t, or the derivative of the x and y components of r prime of t. The derivative of 6 plus 2 cosine t is negative 2 sine t, giving us negative 2 sine t times the unit vector I, and then we have plus the derivative of 5 minus 7 sine t with respect to t, which gives us negative 7 cosine t, or minus 7 cosine t times the unit vector j. And now we need to find r prime of pi over 2, which gives us 6 plus 2 cosine pi over 2 times I plus 5 minus 7 sine pi over 2 times j. Cosine pi over 2 is equal to 0, which gives us 6 times the unit vector I. Sine pi over 2 is equal to 1, giving us 5 minus 7, which is negative 2, giving us minus 2 times the unit vector j. So this is r prime of pi over 2. And now let's find r double prime of pi over 2. Performing substitution, we have negative 2 times sine pi over 2 times I, then minus 7 times cosine pi over 2 times j. Again, sine pi over 2 is equal to 1, giving us negative 2 times I. Cosine pi over 2 is 0, giving us plus 0 times unit vector j, and therefore r double prime of pi over 2 is just negative 2i. Let's go back to the graph one last time to check our work. This is the point on the curve when t equals pi over 2. Notice how the tangent vector, also the velocity vector, does look like it has an x component of 6 and a y component of negative 2, and r double prime of pi over 2, this purple vector, which can also be viewed as the acceleration vector, does look like it has an x component of negative 2 and a y component of 0, verifying our work is correct. I hope you found this helpful.